Hey friends, Suze here from Revelation Quilts. Check out this very cool quilt that I made from one jelly roll, only one jelly roll. Super easy, there's no waste to this project. Let's get started. Okay, so for this project, all we're gonna need is one jelly roll, and I have chosen Dreamy by Modern Quilt Studio. And it looks pretty cool and modern, which I really like. So let me get this open and let's take a look at these gorgeous prints. Okay, so it looks like I picked this jelly roll. One reason is because it's got two of every fabric in here. And so that's what I want. I wanted to pick a jelly roll with two of every fabric. And so that is going to help with this design, because I want one of the fabrics to sew a strip set with, and the other fabrics we will use for the cross strips, so to speak. So I'm going to leave these in the order that they came, and I'm going to separate them out so that I have one of each fabric in one pile, but I'm going to keep them in order like this. And I'm just going to separate them out like so. So that is the first step. Okay, so I've got them all separated out, and lo and behold, when I get to the end of the jelly roll strip, my last two are not the same. They're kind of both dark blue, but they do have a different colorway. So I am going to still use them because I have to stick with my plan. So I'm still going to use them, and hopefully it won't be too noticeable. I mean, they're the same colors, but the colors are just in kind of different places, and they have the same pattern, just kind of different. The colors are switched around. So we're going to hide them in here, and hopefully it won't stick out too much when we do what we need to do. So the next step is we are going to take one of these strip sets. We're going to put the other one aside. We're going to take one of them, and we're just going to sew them all together in one huge strip set. So I'm going to go do that. Just keep them nice and straight, as straight as you can, and you will press all of them to one side. So I'm going to go get busy and sew all of these together in the order that they came off of the jelly roll. Okay, so I've got these all sewn together. They're absolutely gorgeous. And I have it folded in half on my cutting board because the whole thing doesn't fit on my cutting board. And I've got it lined up as carefully as I can. And so I think it's so beautiful. All these colors together is so amazing. And like I said, I sewed them down in the order that they came right off of the jelly roll. That is key to this pattern. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to cut off these selvage edges, and you have to be, you want to be as careful as you can to get this nice and straight on your cutting board, because we are going to be cutting strips on this. So I am just going to start my first cut, and I'm going to cut the selvages off. And I am definitely going to use my weight for this, since I'm kind of half on my board and half off, cutting as straight as I can. Okay, here we go. Okay, oh, did I get it all? I missed a few seams. So make sure you have a fresh blade in here, which I do. Okay, there we go. So I've got the selvages out of the way. And so the next thing we're going to do, we're going to cut 2-inch strips on this. So I'm just going to go down the line and cut 2-inch strips. Now I haven't sewn these ends together, so it's not a strip tube. It's just a strip set that is folded in half. So I'm just going to start at the edge and put my weight down here and start cutting my 2-inch strips. So there we go. I've got my first strip all in a row. So just put these aside. And I think I mentioned that all of my seam allowances are all going the same way. So I'm just gonna lay these maybe across my ironing board, all of them in the same order. And I'm just gonna cut this whole strip set into 2-inch strips. So that is your next step. So go ahead and do that. Now, depending on how long your jelly rolls are, you should be able to get about 21 strips, but for this project, you only need 19. So that gives you some leeway to cut extra strips if you miscalculated a cut or something. So we're not gonna need these. And so I'm just gonna put those aside for something else or another project or a border or something awesome. So that is it. I've got 19 of these strips all laid out and they're all in the same order. And aren't they gorgeous? So we are just gonna keep them that way and in the same order. So the next step is really fun and easy. Okay, so I'm just gonna sew these two together and my top row of my quilt is going to be a solid strip. So I wanna make sure that that is on top. And so I'm just gonna fold that over onto my strip set. And I'm going to leave some room for the selvage and I'm just going to start down a ways. And I just want to make sure that the whole strip is going to be covered and I've got plenty of room. I have a good 4 inches down at the bottom that I have to play with. So I can start down a little ways and I'm just going to sew a 1/4 inch down there. I'm going to sew these two together. So let me go do that. Okay, so I've got that first strip on. Now, and then when you press them, make sure you press them to the long strip. That will make your life so much easier instead of trying to bend that seam allowance over all these seams. So you're just going to start with that and work your way down. Now I'm going to sew the next strip on, going in order. So this first strip matches the first square of my strip set. The second strip is going to match the second square of my strip set. And I'm just gonna iron out this crease that is in my jelly roll piece. And I'm just gonna take that, start down a little ways from the selvage, and I'm just going to sew this one onto there. I might start at the top, or it doesn't matter. Actually, I think I'm gonna start this way because then I can see these seams and make sure that they are lined up really well. So I'm just gonna go down the line alternating between a strip set and whatever the next jelly roll in line is. So I'm gonna go sew all of these together and then let's get them up on the wall. So as I'm sewing these together, I realize I have a pro tip for you. Now I'm getting ready to sew my next strip set on. And I realized that it might be a challenge to get these exactly lined up like I want to. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pin them. And a great way to do that is as I flip this over, I can see the seam line of this where I've sewn my thread. And I'm just going to match that up with the seam of the one ahead of it as best I can. And I'm just going to match that up and I'm just going to take that pin and put that pin right in there so that it matches. And that will help me line these up. I have to give an awesome shout out to Janet Glass for this awesome pin cushion that she makes out of old hankies and doilies. I love this pin cushion. Thank you, Miss Janet. So anyway, yeah, so just line these up as best you can with the seam line and the seam of the one on top of it. So that will help you line these up as you go along. That is my pro tip, something I'm finding out as I'm going along. Okay, so I've got it all together and this is what it looks like after all the rows are done, row by row. I really like the way it turned out. It looks very cool to me. I also did a mock-up of this in solid colors. So that I'm gonna post that here. That's what that would look like, which I think would also be pretty amazing. And it really makes those colors even stand out more. But here's what I found. When I actually went looking for jelly rolls, I found tons of jelly rolls with rainbow colors. But here's what I didn't find. I didn't find jelly rolls that had two of every color in it. And so if I were to send a message to jelly roll makers, I would say either make your jelly roll with 40 or 42 strips that are all different, or make them so there's two of every color. Because all the jelly rolls I found, there was one weird one in there, or some had three and some had two and some had one of every color. So it would be nice if jelly rolls were more consistent. So I might end up having just to make my own jelly roll with two of every color. So you could definitely cut this from yardage. Just cut 2.5-inch strips of, you know, 20 different fabrics. So that's an option too. But jelly rolls need to be more consistent, in my humble opinion. But this is what it looks like. Now, the way it is here, it measures 40 by 66. So it's a lot more narrow than it is wide. So I'm gonna use my leftover strips. And I had about 4 inches of leftover strips from when I sewed all the things together. So I cut them into 1-inch strips, and I'm going to add a border on the top and the bottom. And so that will take care of that, those dimensions a little bit. So it'll be a little more wide than it is long. So let me get the borders on. I'm actually going to do a solid color and then a little strip and then another solid. So let me get those on and we'll see what that looks like. Okay, so I added the borders. I did a solid and then the tiny little 1-inch strip and then another solid. And it just shows up as a little baby pop of color down both sides, which kind of adds to the intrigue of the quilt. I'm going to show you some close-up pictures of that border. And I put it on my design wall up and down this time instead of crossways, because I just like the overall effect of how it goes from one color down to the other color. And I think that looks pretty neat. Again, I think this would be amazing in solids, but I had a hard time finding the right kind of jelly roll with two strips of each color in one jelly roll. That just is really bugging me right now. So anyway, I'm also gonna put it back across sideways and show you what it looks like that way too, because it's too long for my design wall. So after adding those borders, it is now 66 by 50. So that's a little more acceptable. You could even add wider borders to the side to make it more wide across this way. So yeah, I like it. Give it a shot. And thanks again for watching. This is a fun one to make because there was literally no waste in my jelly roll. I just used one jelly roll. That's the part I liked about it. If you like what you see, if you had an easy time following the directions, give it a thumbs up. That really helps my channel and it helps YouTube recognize it and put it out there more so more people can see it. So I appreciate that. Thank you to my subscribers. Thank you to everybody watching. This is Suze signing out for Revelation Quilts.